Hello everyone, welcome back to another short episode. A very important image-based question, box and whisker plot, statistical interpretation with the help of an MCQ. So if you want, before we begin, if anybody wants plus subscription, these are the advantages. You'll get an access to both live and recorded classes. You can compete in live tests and quizzes. You can study on device of your choice. You can also access the QBank with more than 25,000 questions, and very soon we're going to come out with printed notes. Also, you can take iconic subscription, which is an Academy and Prep Ladder both. Special class features is you can download the app, attend these free special classes, interactive live classes, leaderboard challenges, you can get lecture notes, you can just download, and you can get notified about all the classes, and you can read anytime, anywhere. We have a QBank with more than 25,000 questions. Also, we are starting some of the batches from 1st of September, a Focus FMG batch, a Next 2022 batch, a NEET 21 Emergency Room MCQ batch, and a NEET PG 21 last 3 years PYQ batch. So if you want to revise PYQ and go, that is very, very important. Use PSM10 to get a 10% off on any of your subscription. Also, we have a 1 month package which is currently going on. If you still need, you want to join, you can definitely join, and whatever classes you've missed, you can read it, you can listen to the recorded lectures. Next grand test is happening on 28th, and these are some limited offers. 12 month subscription ke saath 2 months free, and 4 year subscription also you can take. Alright, what is this? This is very important. This is a box and whisker plot. Now, what does this box and whisker plot do? Alright, this is used to represent quartiles, and also it comments on the type of distribution. Is it normal? Is it skewed? So, ye jo aap andar box dekhte ho na, isme this is Q1. The middle one we all know is Q2 and Q3. Let's just quickly revise about quartiles. Suppose, what are quartiles? If I have a data set from 0 to 100, so jo quartiles hota hai, Q1, Q2, Q3, they divide my data set into 4 equal parts. So each part is 25, 25, 25 and 25. Maan lo mere paas data set 0 to 200 hai. To sare jo quartiles honge Q1, Q2, Q3, they are going to divide my data set into 4 equal parts. So 200 by 4 is 50. So each interval over here is 50. Aur ye jo median hai na, median ko hum Q2 bolte hai. ठीक है, the middle value. So if you look at this, Q1 is always dividing my data set into 1:3. Q2 is dividing in 1:1 and Q3 in 3:1. That means Q1 में one part is below, three part is above. Q2 में it's exactly equal. And Q3 में three parts are below and one part is above. Alright, so if I say, suppose ask you how many people lie below Q3. Alright, if suppose total sample size is 100, how many of them are below Q3? So it will become 25, 25, 25, 75. These quartiles can also be represented by a box and whisker plot. So this is the box which has the three quartiles. Interquartile range is Q3 minus Q1. This is a measure of dispersion. The whiskers are the tails. Alright? Okay. Now, how will you interpret? What do you think this is? This diagram, does it show you outliers? No. The exactly 50% observations are above and 50% are below. That means both sides are equally distributed. So, this box and whisker plot represents a normal distribution, guys. Alright. Now, look at this image. Okay, if you can see over here, I have given you three images and I want you to comment. So the very first thing that you have to do is, you have to rotate these images clockwise, everybody. So look at the first one. First one jo hai, aise karke bana hua hai. Alright, it's like this. Tails are also equal and the box in between is also equal. So if you rotate it clockwise, guys, it's exactly going to come like this. ठीक है, बीच में ऐसे टेल्स भी इक्वल है और ये भी इक्वल है. सो दिस इज अ नॉर्मल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. नाउ लुक एट सेकेंड वन. सेकेंड वन को अगर आप रोटेट करते हो, ऑल यू हैव टू डू इज रोटेट इट. ऑलराइट, सो इफ यू रोटेट द सेकेंड वन, गाइस, व्हाट डू यू सी? वेयर इज द आउटलायर्स? दिस इज ओवर हियर. यस, वेयर इज द आउटलायर्स लाइंग इफ यू रोटेट इट क्लॉकवाइज? क्लॉकवाइज रोटेट करोगे, सो द आउटलायर्स, द गैप इज मोर ऑन लेफ्ट साइड. ठीक है, गैप इज मोर ऑन लेफ्ट साइड. सो सिंस गैप इज मोर ऑन लेफ्ट साइड, इट इज नेगेटिव साइडेड स्क्यूनेस. ठीक है, थर्ड वाले इमेज को रोटेट करो. लेट्स ट्राई टू ड्रॉ दिस थर्ड इमेज ओवर हियर. इफ यू रोटेट इट एवरी वन, और लेट्स ड्रॉ इट हियर क्लॉकवाइज, ठीक है? अगर आप इसको क्लॉकवाइज रोटेट करते हो तो आपको क्या दिखता है? इफ यू ड्रॉ दिस इमेज क्लॉकवाइज एवरीबडी, आई मीन इफ यू ट्राई टू रोटेट दिस इमेज क्लॉकवाइज, हाउ इज इट कमिंग गाइज? कैसे आएगा ये क्लॉकवाइज जब आप इसको रोटेट करोगे? सो दिस इज like this, okay? So where is your distance maximum? Just rotate it clockwise, clockwise घुमा के देखो. So the gap is more towards the right side, okay? Or positive sided skewness. You just have to remember one golden rule. Rotate clockwise. अब मान लो कि अंदर जो box है वो exactly equal है. Then look at the tail. Whichever side the tail is more, all right, that sided skewness it is. Suppose I draw a graph like this. Okay, now here in the middle it's exactly equal. All right, it's exactly equal. But the tail is prolongated towards the right side, so it becomes positively skewed. All you have to remember is you have to rotate clockwise. जिधर भी gap ज़्यादा होगा, वो उस type का skewness हो जाएगा. This is an MCQ which came in our AIIMS paper. Which of the following statement is correct? Negatively skewed, positively 75% values are above 25, median is 50. So what do you think this is? What I've just taught you, just try to rotate this once. अगर आप इसको rotate भी करते हो guys, ये बीच में तो exactly equal है, but which side the tail is elongated? On the right side. All right, so when you rotate it clockwise, the tail is elongated on the right side. So this becomes right-sided skewness or positive skewness. So definitely that is correct. Now how can you interpret the values? This is Q2, this is Q1 and this is Q3. So Q2 kahan pe lie karega? Just drop a perpendicular almost at 25. So Q2, median is Q2, median is 50? No. What is median over here? Median is equal to 25, and we all know that अगर ये data set है 0 से 100, तो यहाँ पे ये Q1 है, this is Q2, Q3. So Q1 is dividing into 1:3. One part below, three parts above. 25% below, 75% above. Q2 50-50, 50% below, 50% above. Q3 कैसे divide कर रहा है? 75% below and 75% above. So now here 25 mg is the median. तो मीडियन कैसे डिवाइड करेगा? 50% अबव 50% बिलो. सो 75% वैल्यूज अबव इज रॉन्ग, ठीक है? 50% अबव हो जाएगा. इज इट नेगेटिवली स्क्यूड? नो, इट इज पॉजिटिवली स्क्यूड. सो ऑल दैट यू हैव टू रिमेंबर इज अ गोल्डन पॉइंट दैट यू हैव टू फर्स्ट रोटेट इट क्लॉकवाइज, और फिर आप देखो जब आप क्लॉकवाइज रोटेट करते हो तो बॉक्स में गैप किस साइड आता है. अगर ज्यादा लेफ्ट साइड आता है तो इट इज वॉट? Left-sided skewness, which indicates outliers. If the tail is more elongated on the left side, if the box is equal but tail is more elongated on the left side, it's left-sided skewness. And just try to drop the values and remember this rule of quartiles. Okay, I hope you understood. Thank you so much.